In this video, I'll show you a great new feature of the Tile Multiplier add-on in Mazes 2D Tiles. Hi, this is Hans from Book Publisher Tools, and as you can see, we are looking at a fresh maze. And part of this software is the Tile Multiplier. What it does is generate additional tiles if you are too lazy to, or whatever, to create all of them. I'll show you a set of tiles that I created, and this is not a complete set, but I was just testing. And this has one tile with code 1, one with 1-2, that's the corner, two straights, 1-3 from top to bottom, two splits, 1-2-3. This is one that has priority in this corner, and this one has priority on the straight end. A crossing and an ending tile and a start tile that are just an S and F for finish. Now I'll select the tile set I just showed. Here you can see all the tiles. Generate a maze, and as you can see, there are a lot of tiles missing, which was to be expected. And I can click on complement images. And now you can see the full maze because it generated new tiles from the existing ones. That means that I had a dead end. Here's one. This is the one tile dead end from the top. And from that it generated the three tile dead end from the bottom, dead end from the left, and dead end from the right. And so on for all the other types. It gets more interesting when we have 3D tiles. So I'm going to switch to isometric. And as you can see, there are just square tiles, and it's a bit ugly because it wasn't converted yet. Now I'm going to convert the square images to isometric format. And you can see it's a reasonable nice maze. I'll change the solution line a bit. Otherwise we can barely see it. What we can see here is for all of the road tiles, the conversion went okay, but the S and the F are not really pretty like this. So we have an option to not rotate the start and end tiles. And as you can see now, it's just the regular start and the regular F. They are printed on a circle. I'll show you the tile. So this circle will still be there. It will be scaled down a bit. But the reason that you see this little rounded corner here is because of the tile that we printed over it. If you don't want that, then you should edit the start and end tiles in a way that it doesn't happen. I also, in this case, gave the S and F a background that's just identical to the road, and that's not required at all. You can just be creative the way you want, because this tool makes it easy to prototype and test and see if it works or doesn't before you create a full set of tiles. Now the great new feature of the Tile Multiplier is that you can add depth to your tiles. It won't suddenly place buildings on it, but if I click the add depth and don't do any settings besides switching it on, I click next preview, you can see there's a suggested 3D border that suddenly makes it look like a real 3D maze. There are some options for this conversion. For example, you can set the depth. It's a percentage of the height. So right now it's 20% of the tile height. You can set. And now it's, well, looking a bit more solid. I personally like it to add the borders, not too thick, to make it really look like a bunch of blocks grouped together. that's not required. I mean, you can do whatever you like, but this way it just looks like someone put a bunch of blocks together to create a tile. Last but not least, you can set the colors. It is the right depth color, for lack of a better name. That's this area, the right side of the tiles. The left depth color is the left side of the tiles, and you can change this. And there's even an option to automatically derive the left color from the right. So if you want it 20% darker, you can do that here. Or I can say, let's make it 40% darker. You can see it here. And if I click next preview, then you can see a totally different maze. You can also use different colors if you like. So for example, I could use green for the right side and red for the left, and as you can see, you actually get these colors here. That's less of a shading color, because the idea of shading is to make it seem like the light comes from the right, so you have from the top right, so this is a bit darker than the top and this is darker than the right side. So when I click this on again, now have a bright green and a darker green here, and I can set the lines a bit thicker so you actually see the lines here and on all the squares. So don't forget, we started with just these few square tiles. And this means that you can just create a few square tiles yourself. You don't have to do advanced stuff like rotating and scaling it, like I showed you in the Adobe Illustrator tutorial. And you can create your own 3D effect in the mazes. There's one more thing I want to show you right now. And that's the combination of this 3D effect with masks. I'm going to click use masks. This is another add-on, but if you have both of them, you can do this. I'm going to click edit mask. It's just a 10 by 10 mask. It's not very large or whatever. I'm going to edit a bit just to show what can be done. Click use mask, and what you can see here from the few road tiles we started with, we don't only have this 3D effect at the sides, but also when there are holes in the maze because of the mask I just created, you'll see that it adds this effect. And if I would go to style, click transparent, you can see the background colors changed slightly, then you can add background images that will be visible through the maze. So this is another thing, as the combination of the masks and the tile multiplier that you can quickly create.